So this is called as electron self energy or fermion self energy diagram. This is called as vacuum polarization or photon self energy diagram. This is called as vertex correction or vertex modification. So these are the lowest order radiative corrections diagrams in human nature. These are the lowest order radiative correction diagrams in QMD theory. Lots of people, thousands of people are working on these things, making use of them in a commercial basis, the way we do gravity theory here at this group similarly. And these people sitting at LHC, theorists, they do the corresponding theory, and experimentalists, they look for all the outcomes of these things, right? So how do you construct now from the tree level diagram? You construct the higher order diagrams which are physically meaningful. So you can construct, making use of these three fundamental radiative correction diagrams, you can construct higher order diagrams for these processes with the help of these radiative corrections. So let me just demonstrate. Let me call it this, and this is number two. So let me make a space for this. So in the electron-electron scattering, now, so this is the tree level diagram. You can have one fermion self energy diagram. So you, what you do is you insert these three diagrams according to well-defined rules of the Feynman diagrams in your lowest order tree level diagram. So for example, I could insert a fermion self energy diagram here or here or here or here, or here, so let me not show all four of them here. It's enough to show one. You can insert either here or here or here or here. You can insert them at all of them, but then this would be a very higher order diagram. Because look, one E is sitting here. E is a coupling constant of the QED theory, which is a very, very small, tiny number. So this is already a diagram, second order diagram. You have two vertices. You had one, in the three vertices, there was only one vertex. So E was sitting only at one place. Now in the second order diagram, E is sitting here, E is sitting here. Now in addition, E would be sitting here and here. So this is E to the 4, you see. So you multiply 0.01 times 0.01 square. And then if you have further higher order diagrams, you have the raised to the power. So E square, E to the 4, E to the 6, E to the 8. Okay, well, they become more and more negligible as compared to these. So major contribution comes from the grounds, from the lowest order diagram, then next leading order diagram, then next to leading order diagram, and so on. Now, you could also have this is also 1, 2, 3, 4. This is also E to the power 4 diagram. I could also have, now this is I have modified the vertex here, and this becomes E to the power 4 diagram. And so this is also E to the power 4 diagram. So you can collect all these diagrams. What you do is the transition amplitude of a theory is summation over n to infinity a of n lambda to the n. So lambda is the coupling coefficient, which is for EVD theory. Lambda equal to E for electronic charge for EVD theory. Here, this AN is determined by all the Feynman diagrams, all the possible Feynman diagrams for a particular process. If we want to calculate the transition amplitude for a particular process, this is the perturbation theory involving A to AN times lambda to the N. Lambda is the coupling coefficient, which is E for the QVD theory. And these ANs are determined by all the diagrams. So for second order diagram, this is the only diagram, tree level diagram. But for e to the power 4, you can construct, I have written here one, but you can write three more diagrams by inserting it here or here or here. Now there is only one photon propagator, you can insert it here, this one. And vertex correction, you can insert either here or either. So you collect all of them and put them in the, you can construct more higher order diagrams, right? In this also nobody prevents you from putting here, then that would be e to the 6 diagram, right? And so on. But one can introduce one photon self-energy diagram here, for example. So this is how you construct higher order diagrams. So higher order diagrams are constructed using the lowest order radiative correction diagrams in any theory. So this is what we are talking about, the QAD theory, right? You can develop for the Compton scattering in an analogous manner. You could introduce a fermion self-energy diagram here or here or here, right? On these three legs, or you can introduce a photon self-energy here or here, or you could introduce a vertex correction like this, and so on. So you could construct, for any given process, you can construct higher order diagrams. So you have to first know the lowest order fundamental diagrams for any theory. You see, this is what the brave souls have tried to do for gravity theory. You see, so what you do for QVD theory, QCD theory, you have many, many more diagrams. You have 8 gluons, and electrovic theory also W plus minus G, 3 force carriers. So there is a multiplicity of all these diagrams, but younger people are more bright, like you people. They do these things on the computer, no longer in my old fashioned method of doing things on a piece of paper. But then it becomes too clumsy to handle things. So, but anyway, this is the situation. The main point we catch, if we were interested in constructing a correct quantum field theory of gravity, we will have to first write down the fundamental vertex diagrams for the gravity theory. We will have to write down the lowest order radiative correction diagrams for the gravity theory. Then we will have to construct the higher order diagrams for the QVD theory. For example, in the same diagram, one could replace this photon by a graviton. Okay, this is how you would construct. So, in the literature, you see, this means a solid line. A solid line means a fermion propagator. A wavy line means a photon propagator. And this is a general used for bosonic propagator. So and these people use in particular for gluons.
In many string theory books dealing on this topic, you might find the same one describing the graviton. And in some books you will find it like this. In some articles and books, some people use this, the dashed line, to denote the graviton propagator. Okay? And some people denote it by this. Okay. But the QCD people want to reserve it for the gluon propagator. Okay. So there are not too many options, but we know what we are talking about. Okay. So essentially you replace this by a, and so on. Okay. So and if you because I can see my watch, today we lost some time at the beginning, so if we would like to study, let us say, electron-electron scattering via the exchange of gravitons, then we would do a similar exercise and have the graviton propagator everywhere instead of the photon.